Good morning, good morning. Today is Thursday and it is my Greenville day, so I'm headed to Greenville. And why don't you just ride along with me? And y'all know I'm gonna have to stop at the Aldi when I get to Greenville. Y'all know this. So y'all just come with me and we'll see what we can get into today. Y'all, so I totally forgot to show you what I got from Aldi. Let me see. This for sure, okay? I did buy some grapes and a bunch of cheese. And I bought garlic. Pretty much everything you see me have in my hand, I picked up. But I couldn't leave without these. These are adorable. They got pumpkins and little leaf shapes. Just a ball-shaped pasta, so I think, I'm not sure what I'm going to use this for, but it's going to be special. All I've got left out of my little garden is these little cherry tomatoes, and I'm just waiting. It's rained so much, I don't know if they're going to turn red or not, but there's some little guys still here. It's still doing its thing. Good afternoon, everybody. I just finished work. I got a much needed parenting assessment report cranked out, which was wonderful. Those things take so long to write up, they really do. But what I think I am going to do for supper is, I think I'm going to do breakfast. So, I'm going to make some biscuits, and y'all know, I'm going to do my best to kind of, well, I don't go by recipes, but I'll, like, do my measurements, maybe. I have a fourth of a cup here. I think I'm going to put a cup and a half of unbleached flour, so that would be 6 of these. Well, actually, there's not that much left, so I don't really know how much that is, but we're going to work with it. I actually think it's like 2 cups, maybe. But I didn't want to just put like a little half a cup of flour and roll it back up and set that in my cabinet. Didn't want that business going down. Right, and now I'm going to do my baking powder, and I'm going to put, this is a half of a teaspoon. I am going to put a full, maybe 2 teaspoons in, so that'll be 4 of these. I like my biscuits to be fluffy, y'all, and this is the ingredient that does that, just so you know. In case you didn't know, now you know. And I'm going to do some sugar. Boop, 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 boop. these biscuits. Look at me. Okay, I'm putting in about two. I'm doing about 2 tablespoons of sugar. Something. This is all about experimenting. I have some dried milk somewhere. I'll be right back. Well, so I looked and I don't have an open packet of the dried milk, so I'm just going to leave it be. I'm not going to open up a packet for an experiment. Should I find it, I'll just do it again some other time. But I'm going to mix all my dry ingredients up right now. Okay, y'all. So, I had to stop because my daughter was had an emergency. So, what I've got here is I've got about maybe 3/4 of a stick of butter just chopped up into little bitty pieces. And I'm just going to kind of work this in here. Get off there. Gonna kind of smash that in there. I love this little thing here. I went to Hobby Lobby and they were having a huge sale on all of their cake decorating stuff, and this just happened to be in the cake decorating stuff. And I'd been wanting one for a while, but I just wasn't willing to pay the prices that I'd seen them go for. So it was like $3 at the Hobby Lobby, and I was like, okay, thank you, Lord, for blessing your girl. He does do that, you know. He do be like that. He'd be blessing us. All right, so I'm going to get this in here and get it kind of worked in, and then I'll be back. Okay, y'all, so I ended up putting the rest of that stick of butter in there because it just wasn't the texture that I like, but this is kind of how I like it to look. And I'm going to put a little bit of 1% milk in. I'm just going to mix that around. Y'all, I love that Gossamer boxed shelf-stable milk. It is delicious. Now, with these, I don't have to kneadle them. I don't roll them out. I just form them in the palm of my hand. That's what I do. I'm gonna get this mixed up to the consistency that I like it. All right, so I have washed my hands and I'm at the place now to where I can just form my biscuits. I gotta get all that flour in the bottom. But I'm gonna form my biscuits. You know, I should have doubled this recipe and just made extra and put them in the freezer. Why didn't I do that, y'all? Why didn't I do that? Okay, they're kind of sticky. That's okay. That's okay. I'm just gonna kind of, these are like the little cat head biscuits. They're gonna be pokey everywhere. Is it cat hair or cat head? I don't remember what it's called. But that's what these are like. So don't be judgy. They're good. I probably could have put a little bit less milk in there, but it is what it is. Is what it is. I still think they're going to turn out fabulous. Okay, so now I am cooking. My husband likes sausage. Sausage is okay. I'm not like anti-sausage, but it's not my preference. So I'm going to have bacon that I'm heating back up that I cooked yesterday. So, and yes, I'm putting salt and pepper on this sausage because it needs a little kick to it. This is the Walmart sausage in the little 8-packs. So that is what I'm doing. All right, and I'm going to let those cook up a little bit, and then I'm going to scramble some eggs, I think. I think I want scrambled eggs. I'm not sure. But I did break out my little Snoopy fall little spatulas. I sure did. I got 4 of them. And my sausage is ready. And so now I've got my butter melting for the gravy. don't know about this butter. Let's see. Ooh, it smells so good, y'all. I wish y'all could smell that. Then I am just going to put a little bit of unbleached flour. This bag looks different because I had this in a vacuum seal bag. This is one of my vacuum seal portions. I'm just going to mix that right on up in there. And that butter smells really, really good. Alright. Make a nice little roux. What we're going to do, I've got my heat set below medium. It's kind of in between low and medium. That up. I'm going to get a whisk for that. Alright, I'm just going to whisk that right on up. Turn that down on low. That's heating up pretty fast, pretty quickly. You can add as much milk or water as you want into it to your desired thickness. I don't like mine real thick, but I don't like it real runny. I kind of like it in the middle. This is really thickening up fast. Alright. So, now, I'll put my pepper. You gotta pepper it up really good. I'm just going to let this sit and rest. And my husband wants to cook his own eggs, so I'm going to get him in here to cook his eggs. All right, he's in here cooking his eggs.
I've been busted together.
Oh.
I got some right here.
You did, yep. I guess you don't make eggs better than I do you?
I do.
Do you?
I just wasn't prepared just yet.
Oh.
You rushed me in.
Did I? Okay. All right. Let me turn this fire off. I hate to open
it. You want this one?
No, I don't. That's your, honey, these are your eggs. This is your egg.
This pan's not hot enough.
Okay. This is your egg. Do you just want one egg? Do you want two eggs?
Wait, I'm going to do a different one. Because this one ain't even cooking.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. Alright. Y'all, he's being real fussy. He's got his sassy pants on tonight.
Just ignore this egg.
Yeah. This is an intentional mess up. This is my fault.
This is to show her how not to do it.
Oh, is that what it is? Okay. Alright. Okay, so this isn't my fault.
Yeah, because it's not even cooking.
Well, I feel the heat. Did you test the pan before you dropped the egg in it?
You said my egg. You're ready to cook
your eggs. I said I sprayed it down. I'm ready to cook your eggs. I just don't think.
That one's hot.
What, do you want to switch places? Will that make you feel better?
Well, why is that still on?
Well, it's not on. Oh, no, it didn't. Shouldn't have been on.
Is this on?
Let's trade places. Let's trade places.
This one ain't getting hot.
Okay, let's trade places and you can use this one. It's already hot. Okay. Alright. I'm curious. We're gonna go ahead and stop this and wait until his egg gets properly heated. Okay, y'all, we are back. Now he's gonna show me how to make an egg. Take two. Okay. feel weird with me watching you?
No. You watch me.
I stare at you all the time. Okay. So far, it looks good. I know that everybody watching is on the edge of their seats. Are you going to, like, take the pan and...
No, you're going to give me a plate to put this in when it's cooked.
Well, you're cooking your egg.
I'm cooking it. I didn't say it was plating it.
But that's how you become a cook. You plate it also. Not any different than what I do. Are you making one or two?
Two.
Two. Okay. All right. Okay. We're on egg number two. He's almost done with his second egg. I'm not really seeing much difference between mine and yours.
My yolk's not hard.
It will be. Look at that. It's going to be.
I bet you it'll be just as runny as the one if it was straight out of the egg.
You think?
I know it will be.
All right. Let's get it plated up. Your sausage is ready. Let me work on this gravy really quick. Now it is my turn to make eggs. And I'm doing it my way. He told me that he doesn't even let his mom cook his eggs. If they're scrambled, he will. But if he wants them fried, he doesn't. Don't feel bad. I don't feel bad. Yes, you want some bacon?
Yeah, I just don't want you. Mm-hmm.
You just don't want in the camera?
No.
Why?
You know how I am about like pictures and videos of you being taken.
You're so pretty.
Do you know how many pictures I have of myself on my phone?
A lot.
Maybe two.
I could think of a bunch. It might not be good pictures.
Nice,
but...
loving pictures. Something to send home to mom. How many?
I don't know.
Exactly.
I don't ever look at your phone. I don't want to.
You don't.
All right, this is the finished plate, so I'm going to eat this up, and I want to thank you guys for spending some time with me and my family, and after I eat, I'm going to go pester my husband, because he's off work tonight, so, and he loves it when I pester him, so I love you guys, but Jesus loves you more. Bye. Good morning, good morning. Today is Thursday, and it is my Greenville day, so I'm headed to Greenville. And why don't you just ride along with me? And y'all know I'm going to have to stop at the Aldi when I get to Greenville. Y'all know this. So y'all just come with me and we'll see what we can get into today.